Hi, my name's Bonnie Barker, and I'm with BonnieBayCrochet.com, and today I wanted to show you how to make single crochet ribbing. I'm going to show you exactly what we're going to make before we start, so you'll have an idea. Ribbing is just something commonly used at the bottom of sweaters, or you know, even on cuffs. Okay, this is single crochet ribbing. I'm actually showing you the sweater called the Tipperary sweater, a part of the Tipperary sweater vest set, which is one of my designs in the Contemporary Celtic Crochet book, which is now available, thankfully, through both the interweavestore.com and amazon.com. So if you're interested in, you know, learning more of these cabling techniques and turning them into whole projects, I just encourage you to look at that. Okay, so now you know what we're shooting for. This is a nice stitch. It's somewhat of an elastic quality, which is what makes it really nice. Very commonly found in many sweaters, both crocheted, knitted. Very common, nice little tool to have in your toolbox. Now I want to show you an example. I'm going to be working on just a small swatch of two rows of double crochet. The number really doesn't matter. The ribbing can be worked in any multiple, so and that goes both multiples horizontally and vertically. And when I say vertically, I mean the actual length of the ribbing itself. Okay, let me show you, for example, looking back at the sweater again. This is a ribbing of about 13 chains, which gives you about 13 single crochets, which is it's a good 2 to 2.5 inches long. You know, maybe you only want a ribbing that's 1 inch long. In that case, you would use fewer stitches. Okay. So as I work on this, I just wanted you to keep that in mind, that there's no hard and fast rule as to how many chains you start with. It all depends on the type of yarn you're using and how many stitches you need to get the length that you desire. Okay, so I'm going to start off, I'm going to use the multiple of 8 stitches back and forth. So that means I'm going to add one more stitch to make this a chain 9. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And I'm going to simply work single crochet in my chain down the side. And yes, I like working in the side of the chain. I know there's a debate out there in the crochet world as to whether you use the back bump or you use the side of the chain. I've always used the side. I enjoy using that. I see it better. It's easier for me to feel. But if you want to use the back bump of the chain, which would be right back here, you know, feel free to do whatever works for you. That will work just as well as using the side, although I dare say that it's much easier to go into the side. Okay, so what I've done is I've chained 9 and I've single crochet starting in the second chain from the hook and all the way down. Now I need to connect this into my piece for the ribbing. And it really doesn't matter to you, let me just say, first of all, whether you work the ribbing on this side, it doesn't really matter which side is the right side or the wrong side. It's pretty reversible. Okay, so now I'm going to simply work a slip stitch, working through both loops of the V on top. Now I'm going to do that in the next one as well, a slip stitch. Now I'm going to chain 1. Now I'm going to turn. And now this is where the key element of the ribbing comes into play. Now we're going to start by crocheting in the single crochets, but oftentimes that's confused as to where I start. Okay, first of all, don't forget you had a chain 1, and then let me see, is that correct? Yeah, a chain 1 and a slip stitch. Okay, so now we're going to work in the single crochets and the back loop only. Notice, let me take the needle out again, or the hook rather. Actually, I was starting it in the wrong place. We need to account for the chain and 1, 2 slip stitches. So it's almost like we're skipping 3 stitches, but we're not. We're just going for the very first single crochet. So we're going to crochet in the back loop only. That's one. We're not going through both, we're just doing the back loop. That's two, three. I'll try to go a little more slowly. Four, five, six, seven, and eight. We do not work in the turning chain. Not, it would be really hard to if you did. Now we're going to chain one. I'm going to turn our work. Now again, we are going to be working only in the back loop from here on out when we're working the ribbing. Okay, so just the back loop. And you're going to want to probably keep track of the number of stitches because it's really easy for the ribbing to get uneven quickly if you add stitches or you subtract stitches. So you're going to want to count as you go, or if you don't feel like counting as you go, and I don't blame you if you don't feel like counting as you go, what you can do is when you get to the end, just do a quick 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, we have 8. Now we're going to do working through both loops on the main piece, slip, stitch, and we're going to do that again. Working through both loops, slip, stitch, chain one, turn, and remember now we're going to not work in this. This is our turning chain, and that's a slip stitch, and that's a slip stitch. This is our first single crochet. It's really, really easy to get messed up on that, and we're just working in the back loop. Okay. And I'll get to the end of this row. I'm going to chain one to turn. Turn. And again, just working in the back loop. I'm just going to do a few stitches here. Okay. All right, so you can already see how this is coming together. You can see the ripple effect, and you see the texture there, and it's nice and stretchy. It kind of gives. That's why it's really a nice stitch for collars, for ribbing around sleeves and around bottoms of sweaters, and makeup. You can put it on the bottom of scarves. There's a whole host of things you can do with this stitch. So hopefully, I've demystified that for you. Take care. God bless.